Now, having finished the rest of the dress, what you need to do is you will need to turn the hemline of the lining before you actually stitch the outer side of the garment. Now, the hemline, we're going to do this about a 1.5 inch turning. Towards the inside, we need to do both the front and the back hemline because these pieces are going to be attached together, and once attached, it's difficult to turn the inside of the hemline. And so prior to doing the outer side seams, we're going to finish the inside of the garment off. Having stitched that down, we need to finish off the outer side seams of the garment. And so starting at the armhole, we're going to little bit difficult when it's slightly slippery. Pin these into place and actually start off not from the corner but a slightly bit in from the corner, because what that does is the machine pushes the fabric and sometimes it's difficult to stitch the two together. So we're sewing the four pieces together here, working downwards, working at a margin of 2 centimeters away from the edge, evening all the edge of the fabric, even up your edge of the fabrics. You know, one of the hardest parts of teaching is actually coming up with the right words when you're actually doing the recordings. My full knowledge is actually in the sewing itself, not the talking part of it. The description becomes quite difficult to actually carry out, believe it or not. And sometimes when I'm actually doing the recordings, the words tend to escape me on what it is that I'm going to say. So do bear with me if I say the odd word which is out of tune or out of line, then that's something that you will have to bear with me, and I've gone and made a mistake here. Without realizing, one of the pieces has just gone and escaped. I was stitching the four pieces together, and then see, when you're trying to concentrate on talk and work at the same time, you tend to lose it, right? What happened in my haste and in trying to fine-tune my sentences, I've gone and messed up the dress. I'd gone out yesterday and I was at I was waiting around. I very rarely get time to read or anything, and I'd gone with one of my family members to a hospital appointment. And you know how you are at hospitals, you're waiting around for ever and ever, and you get bored out of your brain, especially a person like me who is very active and who is a constant workaholic. And it actually took us about an hour and a half at the hospital, where we had to sit around And I got really fed up, to be honest. So I was going through the magazines, and you know how you do at the waiting room, you're trying to read up, catch up with all the missed gossip and all the information and all the. So I was sat in the waiting room, and I was going through all the written stories, and there was an article that I was reading, and it was about stress levels, that women tend to suffer more from sleep deprivation, and a few other facts that it had written down. And the reason why they had given that was that women's brain tends to work a lot harder than men's brains, and women are multitaskers, which is a fact. And it just made me think, actually, that this is just one of the, you know, things where I'm trying to multitask here, but on the whole, we are big multitaskers, where we're trying to do like 10 jobs at once. Even when you lie in bed, I mean, with me, I often have a lot of customers coming in and saying, you know, when you go to bed, you must be. And I said, yeah, I probably do all my designs when I actually go to lie down in bed, and I think of all the words. You know, if I'm going to do a speech or something, I think of all the words that I'm going to say, but then by the day after, I'd forgotten everything that I'd gone through in my head the night before, because something else will pop up. And but lately I've become very, 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 very misplaced. Misplaced in the sense that I actually often put things and I forget totally, especially written work. I forget where I, my books and my papers are all over the place, and I'm very badly organized at the moment. So that's with running around trying to do too much. Now we have got a slight problem of the edges over here not meeting up. And this is probably due to the fact that I've actually gone and turned the one piece slightly more than the other. Now what I will do is, this piece that I've actually turned over more, I'm going to slightly open it up and even this out. This is something that I should have done before, and measured them so that they did come out exactly right. But like I said, in my haste, I've got about 10 minutes to actually finish this off and do an alteration to a neckline on another dress before I stand to actually open the shop. So this is another thing, problems of trying to multitask. When you're trying to do too many things at the same time, you end up running into problems. Probably the one of the biggest regrets of my work that I have. I started to teach the sewing, and when I started teaching this, I was already committed and with a lot of workload on other projects. Now, unfortunately, I love the sewing and the teaching aspect of it, and yes, to a degree, I see this as my future, but. The problem is now is that because I'm committed on the other projects, it's very, very difficult to get out of those to try and fully concentrate on this. So until I resolve the other issues of my working life, it's very difficult to actually totally give my 100% to the sewing projects. So this is the reason why you see me a lot of the time in haste. I'm trying to do all the jobs at once, and I'm trying to sort of multitask into doing all the jobs at once, because obviously I have the commitment with the shops, with the other workloads. Now, I am going to come back to this and overlock all the inside of it, but I just want to quickly show you the result of the finished garment, and that basically is what it looks like. It looks very, very effective and very pretty. I just need to overlock and press this into place.